So today's discussion is all about sleep animals. Do you know what type of animal you are in bed? Well, now that I got your attention, get your mind out of the gutter, because what I basically want to talk to you about today are chronotypes. So in case you're unfamiliar with the term, a chronotype is the natural timing of your circadian rhythm. Your circadian rhythm is your body's clock that dictates the time in which you're sleepy, you are alert, when you're hungry. It also controls the timing of digestion, your body temperature, and even wound healing. And the list goes on and on. So we used to think that there were only really two main chronotypes, night owls and early birds. Well, we know humans are much more complicated than that. So luckily, world-renowned sleep expert Dr. Michael Bruce has expanded upon those definitions and has identified four main chronotypes. We have the lion, the bear, the wolf, and the dolphin. So today, I want to describe what it means to be each chronotype and how to know what animal you are and what challenges you may face based on your animal and how you can overcome those challenges. That way you can optimize sleep and energy. So first up are the folks that are first up, the lions. Those lions, they are the king of the jungle. They are typically the bosses and leaders in our world. Their philosophy is early to bed, early to rise, and they typically get more done before 8 o'clock than most of us get done all day. Now, being a lion is a wonderful thing. They're very efficient and productive, and they excel at the workplace. The issue with being a lion is they typically lack when it comes to their social lives because they just can't stay awake to socialize in the evening. So what is a lion to do? First, what I recommend is instead of kickstarting your day with exercise, lions typically like to hit the ground running literally, I would move exercise to after working hours. What that's going to do is it's going to increase your cortisol levels, which is the alert hormone, to give you energy to stay awake in the evening. Now, when you go out with your friends, make sure that you avoid carbohydrates. Carbohydrates convert into serotonin, which converts into melatonin, the sleepy hormone. And in addition, stick to just one drink. The problem with alcohol is that it does lead to a good time, but it can make our lions extra sleepy because it's a sedative. Also, what it does is it increases adenosine. Adenosine is a chemical that connects to the neurons in our brains and makes us sleepy. So just stick to one drink. And if you do that, you should be able to make it to at least 10 o'clock so that you can enjoy dinner and drinks with friends. Next up are the luckiest of all chronotypes, the bears. That's because the majority of the population, about 50% of us, are bears. I am a bear. And what a bear is somebody whose body follows the solar schedule. You typically fall asleep a few hours after sunset and rise with the sunrise. Bears are very social animals. They have a very high sleep need. They typically need about 8 hours of sleep. And the reason they're so lucky is because the world revolves around bears. Our work and social schedules are adapted to a bear's biological clock because it's the majority. Now, the problem with being a bear, it's not without its challenges, is that bears are social creatures and they typically like to stay out a little bit too late, especially during the week, and they don't get enough sleep. And the issue with that is that sleep deprivation builds throughout the week, and then come the weekends, they're extra sleepy, and so they take advantage of not having to go to work and they sleep in. They'll catch up on sleep on Saturday and Sunday, and then they also typically stay out later. So as a result, their circadian rhythm shifts. And what that means is that their melatonin is going to start pumping later in the evening. So then come Sunday night, when they have to go to bed at the normal time, say, 11 o'clock, they're not going to be sleeping until 12. So they're going to lie awake, stressing out about the fact that they can't sleep, which makes it even more difficult to fall asleep. And then they start Monday on a bad note. They don't get enough sleep on Sunday night. And then what happens, it takes a couple days for their body clock to shift earlier again. And then by the time it does, they do it all over again over the weekend. So what I recommend for the bears is to aim to get 8 hours of sleep a night and to stick to a consistent bedtime and wake up time, even on the weekends. Also, a problem that bears experience is that they get a 3 p.m. slump. They usually have low energy around 3 p.m. And I know what I do. That's when I want to grab for coffee, especially a sugar-filled latte. Now, the problem with that, it's not really going to sustain your energy levels. All it's going to do is just give you a boost of adrenaline because of the sugar in it, and also help you to feel a little bit more alert due to the caffeine. But the problem with having caffeine that late, it could affect your ability to fall and stay asleep at night. And then the sugar is going to make you feel even more tired once that effect wears off. So instead of grabbing for that sugary latte, what I would recommend doing is to take a little break. What you need at 3 o'clock is really to rest. If you work at a progressive company or work from home, it's a really good time to get a little power nap. Now keep it just to 20 minutes or else you may feel even more groggy when you wake up. If a nap is out of the question, you can take a walk around the block, do a little meditation, deep breathing, or call a friend. So do yourself a favor, do your waistline a favor. Instead of reaching for a high calorie snack and especially caffeine, take a little break, and that's going to recharge your battery and help sustain your energy throughout the evening. So let's talk about those wolves. The wolves are some of my favorite people in the world. They are the creatives. They typically work in the entertainment or advertising industry. They are the artists, and their creative juices usually flow late at night. So they typically stay up late and then sleep late in the morning. And that's totally fine if they work a position that allows them to keep late hours. However, for those wolves out there that work a 9 to 5, their chronotype can make it really challenging for them to have energy in the morning. So what I recommend for those folks is that in the morning, when they wake up, is to try to go outside and do a little exercise. What that's gonna do is the sunlight is gonna help to increase their cortisol level, as is the exercise, and that's gonna give them the boost of energy they need to make it through the morning. Now, they don't need to run a marathon in the morning because they probably aren't going to have a lot of energy. What they can do is simply, when they're commuting to work, they can get off at a stop, maybe a couple stops sooner, so that they can walk a little bit to the office or park further away from the office. Just a little bit of exercise, 15 minutes, and spending some time outdoors is really all you need to get that full effect of a nice cortisol influx. Also, what I recommend that the wolves do is that they stay away from late night snacking, because that's going to pack on the pounds. What wolves typically do is they'll eat with their family, around 6 o'clock, and then they have the munchies come 10 o'clock at night. So what I want you to do instead is have a late day snack to control your blood sugar, make sure that it contains protein, and then eat dinner around 8 o'clock. That's going to help keep your blood sugar stable, so you're not reaching for those Fritos at 11 p.m. Last but not least are the dolphins. The dolphins are highly intelligent, but also highly neurotic. They would totally take over the world if they could only get some sleep. These are the insomniacs. And the reason why they're insomniacs is they cannot turn off their brain. That's why they're called the dolphins, because dolphins sleep with only 50% of their brain shut down, just like insomniacs. Now, the problem with this is that, the dolphins don't get good sleep. They have issues falling asleep and staying asleep, and we all know how important sleep is. Sleep, of course, gives us energy, but it's also important for our immune system, our metabolism, and our emotional and physical health and well-being. So we need these dolphins to get better sleep so that they can truly shine and live happy lives. So if you are a dolphin, what I recommend that you do is at the end of the day, do a brain dump. Take out a notebook and just write about all of your worries. Get it all out. I also want you to write a to-do list and also some thoughts that you have around your sleep, especially if they're negative. And take a look at those thoughts and ask yourself, are those 100% true? If they're not, try to think of something more, a more positive statement. Now, once you got everything out in on paper, do a quick little meditation, maybe 5 minutes or some deep breathing, so that you can completely decompress and settle your mind. And what this is going to prevent is you being wide awake at 3 o'clock in the morning, thinking about the laundry list of things that you have to do. Now, also, if you're a dolphin, I recommend eating some carbohydrates with dinner. The reason why, like I mentioned before, is that carbohydrates convert into serotonin, which then converts into melatonin, the sleepy hormone, and that's going to help you to sleep. Another thing that's important for dolphins is to have realistic expectations in terms of their sleep needs. Dolphins typically have a lower sleep need than the rest of us. A lot of them only need 6 to 7 hours of sleep. And what I find dolphins do is because they're not getting good sleep is they go to bed too early and then they don't have enough sleep pressure to make it through the night, and that further exacerbates their night wakings. So I would lean more towards a later bedtime, maybe somewhere between 11 to 1 o'clock, depending on what time you wake up during the day, and aim to get 6 to 7 hours. So if you still don't know what your sleep animal is, what I recommend doing is to check out the website, The Power of When. You can take a short quiz to help you figure out your chronotype, and you'll also sign up for Dr. Michael Bruce's newsletter, and he'll provide you with tips for your sleep animal. Now, if you have any further questions about this, you can also reach out to me. I'm always happy to help. You can email me at kelly@kellymurraysleep.com, or you can set up a 30-minute chat with me through my website if you're interested in working one-on-one with me. And my website is Kelly Murray Adult Sleep. So I hope that this information is helpful and translates into more sleep for you so that you can feel and be your best. Sweet dreams.